this continuation of the Cytoscape lab, we will have a walkthrough of analyses that you can do with a simple network, and I will also briefly introduce you to other tools like Gephi and so on that exist for network analysis. There is also a very interesting MATLAB toolbox called MATLABBGL, which we will look at in a later class.
So, let us maybe play around with a simpler, very simple network. So, now I know what node has the highest betweenness centrality and so on, and I can have different types of layout algorithms as well. So,
we can feed in our algorithm
for layout. No. So, there are built in algorithms. You can write an app if you want, you can have all kinds of layouts that you can imagine. Usual nice layout is organic, it lays it out usually quite nicely. So, there are various layouts that are possible. You can even manually lay it out, which you may often do for a smallish network if you are trying to explain something or, you know, preparing an illustration. This, as you see, is a substantially large network. It has about 3900 nodes, and yeah, see, and you can easily analyze this also using Cytoscape. Yeah, so you see that was pretty fast. Let us look at the degree distribution. So, let us try to fit up our law. Yeah, got a good correlation and an R squared value. When you look at the degree, you have points even with the degree of 524. Huge. There is one node which has 524. Let us try to visualize that. You can easily capture where that node is. So, map node size to degree and map node color to betweenness centrality. If you want, we can even map edge size to edge betweenness. There you go. So, let us now zoom into it. It is going to be a little tricky. Yeah. It is really a dense network. So, what you can do here is, you can just select nodes and you can look at all the So for example, let's say you want to, okay, let's again do the network analysis, network analyzer, analyze network, undirected. Let's look at some parameter like characteristic. So what's the network diameter is 13, right? So now let's take the top degree nodes right. So you have something with 524 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. I have now picked the top 10 degree nodes. So I'm only selecting these nodes and delete those nodes, right? So let's probably just take a screenshot of this. And let's again analyze the network. Let's see. So let's just look at least the diameter. Diameter was 13 and characteristic path length was 4.321. Let's see how that changes. Yeah. So for 4.321, it became 4.826. So, but the diameter just varied by 1. Not a big deal. Okay. Now let's take between a centrality.
Again, we have to analyze in the beginning, right?
True, but we can just, we're just doing some random perturbations here, so we can try and mix the perturbations. I think this between a centrality of 1, let's see what these nodes are. I'm not sure if they are, they could be nodes in this other components. Maybe we should restrict ourselves to this component.
Sir, is it possible to take the single most character component, like big single most character component, so that we can?
So there is one way to do it. So let's just take this node. I know it's part of that connected component, and I just go to tools and select and nodes. First neighbors of selected nodes, right? So I can do Control 6. Okay. So that has now selected this entire component. Control 6 was to select the neighbors of my nodes. I did that recursively, right? You do that a few times, you do that 14 times basically, you are guaranteed to capture the entire network, right? So now edit. Select nodes, inward selection, Control I, delete. Now I have just the single component. So now let's look at shortest path. It says 663%. Now I think that should come up to 100%. Tools, network analysis, analyze network. So all nodes are obviously connected by, connected to one another. Diameter is the same. Diameter 1 degrees. Well, not necessarily. So if you had another, cluster which was like a really bad linear chain, you could have the diameter decrease. Let's now look at the degree distribution. So clustering coefficient, network clustering coefficient is only 0.037, but let's look at the this is CK versus K. This is interesting. Now let's try to, now let's take between us. The highest between us is only this much. Let's pick. Let's see if this even breaks it, breaks the network into some more components.
Should be a function of k. Should be a function of degree. It should be.
Simple parameters. And tools. So now, yeah, you already had some disconnections. You see the shortest paths has gone down to 93%. By just picking the top 5 between a centrality nodes and deleting them, I think we created some more components in the network.
But the diameter is not changing.
The diameter is not changed. Not necessarily that it should change, right? Those components are smaller.
At least the path length should increase, right?
So let's just try to delete this and we'll see what. Oh yeah, you have so many disconnected nodes. I deleted the single largest component and now you have so many disconnected nodes. Let's lay them out again. Yeah, this is completely disconnected because of, they probably, you know, they didn't have any other neighbors other than that sort of hub node to which they were connected. But essentially the idea through this sort of lab session is to highlight what are the nice things that one can do with Cytoscape. So as you must have understood today, it's a very powerful tool for visualization. Right? You can easily visualize any parameter that you want. You want to visualize between a centrality or closeness centrality or degree, it's just one click. Right? But you know how to do it for more complex things. The other useful thing to know is you have an edge table and a network table here and a node table. So all the node properties will be here. Any edge properties will be here, usually not many edge properties, I think you will have edge betweenness. Yeah, these are basic things, maybe let's look at a simpler network like the one we generated. So, you see there are actually no edge properties at all, that is like interacts with combined score, the score is of course an edge property and yeah. So, if you want even here you can do things like, you can select all the nodes with the highest score and so this was a 990 network, you can already just, you know, you want to keep only the 999 edges. This is not the best way to do it as you can imagine, right, but you can just select it and delete it from here and so on. Right, so I have gotten rid of all those edges. So, this is useful for smaller networks, right, if you are analyzing a particular network. I think some useful analysis you can do with Cytoscape are like what you can do with the string app, right. You pick a particular protein of interest like say P53 or whatever and look at the immediate neighborhood around that because there is a lot of interesting action happening there and that you can sort of analyze very nicely using Cytoscape. Look at the immediate neighborhood and you figure out what are the important proteins there and so on. One hop or even two hop neighborhood. I think that's quite useful to look at. So hope you have understood this visualization part, right? That's very useful. Like how do you do a discrete mapping, a pass-through mapping and continuous mapping and so on, because that is central to visualizing any complex network. Yeah. I usually have some issues with this zoom in, zoom out and so on. Right. Occasionally that's an issue, but otherwise I think Cytoscape is very powerful.
I think we can do discrete and continuous mapping in MatlabBGL, but I don't know how will we do pass-through mapping.
Oh, how will you do discrete mapping and continuous mapping in MatlabBGL? You can't. The plotting is very poor in MATLAB. How do you even visualize it? You don't have any nice visualization algorithms. Maybe there are a few bundled. It's not part of BGL. It might be part of the MATLAB. But NetworkX is good. NetworkX has several visualization algorithms. The other tool that I think one might want to study is Gephi. It's a very powerful tool for doing all kinds of network analysis. And again, you can make pretty nice pictures with it and so on. So, there are many tools. I think the most popular amongst them are Gephi and Cytoscape. The good thing is that they are all cross-platform. You can run them on Windows, Mac, Linux, whatever you want. Yeah, there are many clustering algorithms that you can run as well. So there are also a few things you can do in a programmatic way as well with Cytoscape. So that's quite useful as well. You can access several of the Cytoscape commands programmatically. I think there's also a terminal and so on. So there's a command line dialog where you can do several things. And I think Cyrest is also useful. This also talks to Network X. And after that, you can use Cytoscape tools. Right, you can apply layouts, networks, basically the GUI commands. Okay, I think we'll stop here for today. And this was basically to recap, you know, to follow up with the networks module. And this is something that's important to know, right? What are all the tools? So you should explore Gephi and Cytoscape and any other tools on your own. So Cytoscape, we've had some sort of an introduction today, but there are other useful tools that exist too. Okay.
So I hope you have a good understanding of how do you work with at least simple networks in Cytoscape, and the concepts aren't very different if you want to work with a more complex network, although it will get little less responsive and you'll have more challenges in visualization and so on. And there are many more tools other than Cytoscape that one can use to study networks. In the next video, I'll introduce you to, we'll continue with another lab wherein we'll look at the MATLAB Boost Graph library, which is an old yet very useful toolbox for MATLAB to analyze networks. We'll also look at how do you build a regular lattice in MATLAB and how do you rewire it and so on.